so I cannot go to the front, as I'm all the friends and good ones, they are so. Lord, God, the highest and our peace among the world, God. Lord, God, the highest and our peace among the world, God. Lord, God, the highest and our peace among the world, God.
The mother of God and every virgin.
of all wisdom, let us be attentive.
Bring the boy to me. When they did so, the spirit caught sight of Jesus
and immediately threw the boy into convulsions. He fell to the ground and began to roll around and foam at his mouth. Then Jesus questioned the father, "How long has this been happening to him from childhood?" The father replied, "Often he throws him into fire and into the water. You would think that it would kill him. If out of kindness of your heart, you can do anything to help us, please do." And Jesus said, "If you can. Everything is possible to a man who trusts." The boy's father immediately exclaimed, "I do believe. Help my lack of trust." Jesus, on seeing the crowd rapidly gathering, reprimanded the unclean spirit by saying to him, "Mute and deaf spirit, I command you, get out of him and never enter him again." Shouting and throwing the boy into convulsions, it came out of him. The boy became like a corpse, which caused many to say, "He is dead." But Jesus took him by his hand and helped him to the feet. When Jesus arrived at the house, his disciples began to ask him privately, "Why is it that we could not expel it?" And Jesus told them, "This kind can drive only by prayer." They left that district and began the journey to Galilee. But Jesus did not want anyone to know about it. He was teaching his disciples in this vein: "The Son of Man is going to be delivered into the hands of men who will put him to death." 3 days later, after his death, he will arise.
Glory be to you, O Lord. Glory be to you.
Today, during this liturgy, we pray for the repose of the soul of Muriel Bisham, offered by Charmaine McKinley. And short announcements as we enter the church. There are printed bulletins. It's still much shorter, and so please access our website for the longer version of the bulletin. But this is there are readings, so we are really working to really better them every Sunday. We haven't had printed for a while, but you know there are parts that the cantors do, and you can read them, follow them by reading with them. And as you notice, our churches now are open, and the restrictions are lifted. So share that with people. Hopefully they know that. I know there was a dispensation that, you know, watching the Divine Liturgy, Holy Mass on TV was equivalent of being in the church. It is not. So that dispensation was lifted. So days, the Sundays and days of obligation are to be in the church. And there is obviously less crowd in church on Saturday, so those who are still, you know, and that applies to each and everyone, even though masks are lifted, but they're more than welcome to wear the mask if that makes you really feel better and safe for you. And there is a hand sanitizer, so use it as air. So be kind and respectful towards each other. Next, this coming Thursday, as we always have the Divine Liturgy in the morning, so it was last minute I was able to get another priest from our neighborhood, a neighboring parish, the Polish parish, the Queen of Peace, Father Jan Burczyk will come, and he will hear the confession. So instead of 9 a.m., I will have 6 p.m., and hopefully he will also have short homily reflection as we're approaching closer to Lent. Father Burczyk is the member of the Michaelites Fathers. And I already put in the bulletin scheduled for Easter, so Holy Thursday, we'll have the Divine Liturgy on the Holy Thursday at 6 p.m., then Good Friday, 3 p.m., Vespers with the procession and placing the shroud, and then 10 a.m. on Saturday, and then 8 starting on Easter Sunday. So long, you know, series of services. We start with praise of the tomb, and then we go to Resurrection Mountains, and conclude the Divine Liturgy and blessing of the food. So if you're not Ukrainian, so or we're not expatriate, Polish people have the same thing. So it's a very beautiful tradition. We bless food to church, to be blessed. What you will eat on Easter Sunday, you will bring to the basket to church, and then I bless that. But don't be literally what you will consume, because it did happen. So every, so we will go series of blessing, you know, we
with the priest. And once when I was at my first parish in Toronto, when I came across, looked very suspicious. So, and it was really in the mask. And I said, and they said, what do you mean? It was actually a bottle of liquor. I said, I meant everything you will consume on Sunday, but that would not apply to alcohol. So one put alcohol into the basket, food, and they shared that, and then eggs, and you know, Easter bread, and whatever it is, closer to Easter, I would put actually the scripture. We can go to that basket more than it's not about the Ukrainians, about something that you waited for this Easter for so long. And now you will share that food as a first meal on that Easter Sunday, something that was blessed on Easter Sunday. And every Friday we have Stations of the Cross. And this coming Monday, we continue with fundraiser for those the victims of the war, for the refugees, and ladies actually will do so if you have nothing to do on Monday morning, so more than welcome to come and join our ladies in the kitchen. They will do pierogies, make the pierogies, and the following Saturday we'll do that fundraiser, even by selling them, and children will paint the Easter eggs. In the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. So sometimes we stand before God with more actually doubt than belief, with more despair than hope. And that probably applies to people in Ukraine, more despair than hope. Sometimes our worries and fears increase. The joy of life slips away and we feel actually rotten. Maybe it is because of our health, maybe the problems in our family, our loved ones, stress about extremely busy schedule, or other matters, whatever that is. We are sometimes simply at the end of our rope. So if you feel that way, or ever you had in your life, we can begin to sympathize with the father of this demon-possessed young man in today's gospel. Since childhood, his son had life-threatening seizures and convulsions. With the broken heart of a parent who has little hope for his child's healing, the man cries out, "Lord, I believe. Help my unbelief." Different gospel, different trust. This one was about trust, but probably many times you will hear, "Lord, I believe, but help my unbelief." Christ's disciples, they lacked the spiritual strength to cast out the demon, but the Lord himself healed this young man. We can only imagine how grateful the man and his son were for this blessing. Disciples' concern in that moment seems to have been only really from themselves. They were not really talking about boy, or they were really more talking, why couldn't we help this young man or this boy? And very harsh words, or straightforward words of crying that really applies to each and everyone. This kind cannot be driven out by anything but by prayer and by fasting. So he made it clear that they lacked the spiritual health as well. They had neglected the most basic practices for the healing of their souls, and consequently were powerless in the face of such great evil. As the Lord said, they were part of the faithless generation. So in fact, the best example of faithfulness in this story is the unnamed father. He wants help for his child. And he tells the truth about himself. His faith was not perfect. He had doubts. His hopes for his son's healing had been crushed so many times before. He said to Christ again, different translation, this gospel uses different words, but many times you would hear, "If you can do anything, have compassion on me." So in other words, he did not really believe himself fully. He wasn't really entirely sure if Christ can help and heal this young man, "If you can do anything." All that he could do was cry out with his tears. Lord, I believe, but how my unbelief? And in doing so, he showed that he had the spiritual clarity that the disciples lacked. For he knew the weakness of his own faith. Still, with every ounce of his being, he called for the Lord for mercy. He received it, and the young man was set free. So if we have taken Lent seriously all this year, we will have become at least a bit like this honest father, when our struggle with spiritual discipline have shown us our own weaknesses. When we pray, we often become welcome distractions to our life. And it's so easy actually not to pray at all. So we set out to fast from food or something else, to which we have become too attached. We often become angry and frustrated. When we try to forgive and be reconciled with others, memories of past wrongs and fears about the future often overcome our good intentions. We wrestle with our passions just a bit, and they get the better of us. We so easily do think and say things that are not holy at all. We put so much else before loving God and people around us. Lent is good at breaking down our illusions of our own holiness and giving us a clear picture of our spiritual state. And often we do not really like what we see. If that's where you are today, take heart. For Jesus Christ came to show mercy upon people like the Father in our today's gospel. The man knew his weaknesses. He did not try to hide it. And he honestly threw himself on the mercy of the Lord. He made no excuses. He did not justify himself. He did not complain. He did not hide his doubt and frustration before the God. He did not wallow in wounded pride, obsessed with his imperfections, or worry about what someone else would think of him. Instead, he simply acknowledged the truth about his situation and called upon Christ with every ounce of his being for help with a problem that had broken his heart. We don't even know if this man was religious. There's nothing in the gospel that he was a pious and religious man. Perhaps his prayers had always been focused on his boy's healing. But we do know that this man, in humility, in honesty, received the mercy of Christ when he called upon him. So with whatever level of spiritual clarity we possess, with whatever amount of faith in our souls, with whatever doubts or fears, weaknesses, and sins that beset us, let us all follow his example of opening the wounds of our hearts and lives to the Lord. And he will do the same for us when we really honestly fall before him in honest repentance, knowing that our only hope is in that the grace and the great mercy that he has always shown to sinners, like you and me. If we need a reminder of the importance of taking a confession this Lent, this gospel should really help us. Christ did not reject a father who was brutally honest about his imperfect faith, but instead responded to his confession with abundant grace, healing, and love. He will do the same for each and every one of us who stand before him with this plea, but honest plea, plea for forgiveness. So with those words, Lord, I believe, help my unbelief. There's no better way to prepare to follow our Savior to the agony of the cross and the joy of the empty tomb. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Let us all say with our whole soul and mind, let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty Lord, to our fathers we pray, hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, in the greatness of your compassion. We pray, hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, so may the most holy verse of Fountain, Francis, Paul, Rome, he's the Adam, Baker, Celestial, most reverend, Mr. Ponta, Lawrence, and God, Dami, Bishop, Ryan, all those who preach thee, those who serve and serve the Holy Church, spiritual fathers, mother of earth, in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, for praying for the nation and the brother God and those who protect us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
We also pray to Almighty Lord, God, our Father, to deliver Ukraine from all evil. May he have mercy and heal this land. May he give Ukraine peace and chance to develop as a nation that values truth, justice, and freedom, all within the goodness of God. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
We also pray for the people near Christ and who pray but for mercy. Those be kind to us for all Orthodox Christians.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Give glory to your Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen.
Again and again, keep
for those increased, the Yatma, religious and monastic orders, our civil authorities in all armed forces, blessed founders, benefactors of this Holy Church, all of you Orthodox Christians, now and forever and ever.
Holy, holy.
may you grant the precious blood of your Christ. Amen. Within the chalice, the precious blood of your Christ. Amen. Changing them by your Holy Spirit. Amen. 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 Especially her most holy mother, the most blessed Lord Lady, the Mother of God and ever Virgin Mary.
In you, O full of grace, all creation rejoices. The angelic ranks and all the human race, sanctified temple and spiritual paradise, virgins' pride and boast, from when God was made flesh and became a little child, and he who is our God before all ages, and he made your room a throne and made it wider than all the heavens. In you, O full of grace, all creation rejoices. Glory be to you.
Among the first, remember, Lord, the most holy, universal Pontiff Francis, Pope of Rome, his beatus, Peter, Silas, most reverend, Metropolitan Lawrence, God, Father, Bishop Ryan, for the sake of all the churches, grant that they may live in peace, safety, honor, and health for many years, and rightly impart the word of your truth.
And they remember all men and all women.
And grant that with one voice, one heart, we glorify, sing the praises, your most honored, uplifting name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen.
In the mercy of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
And in the name of the saints again, and again, in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the precious gift that we presented and consecrated, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Spiritual front that upon his holy heavenly mystical altar may send down on us in return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
In all tribulation, wrath, and misfortune, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help and save, have mercy, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask the Lord.
Bring his soul.
Angel, peace, and guide and govern their own souls and bodies, let us ask the Lord.
Bring his soul.
For the forgiveness, remission of sins and offenses, let us ask the Lord. For the world, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For his tender rest, for rising peace and repentance, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For our minds, one is faint and unashamed and peaceful, for a good defense and the awesome tribunal of Christ, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For your faith, fellowship of the Holy Spirit, let's commend ourselves and one another, whole life to Christ our God.
To you, Lord.
partaking of your holy mysteries, O Lord. Be unto me not for judgment or condemnation, but for the healing of soul and body. God, be merciful to me, a sinner. God, cleanse me of my sins, and have mercy on me. I have sinned without number. Forgive me, O Lord.
Approach with the fear of God and with faith.
Thank you.
Christ was right here, give thanks to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help and save, have mercy, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Lead us the whole day to be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless. Let's commend ourselves and one another, whole life to Christ our God. Now and forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace.
In the name of the Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Bless those who bless your Lord and sanctify those who trust in you. Save your people and bless your inheritance. Protect the fullness of your church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of your house. And glorify them by your divine power. Do not forsake us who hope in you. Grant peace to your world, to your churches, to the priests of a nation, O God, our government, all your people. And for all good giving and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from you, the Father of lights, and give glory, thanks, and worship to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Thank you. protection against the wickedness and snares of hell. May God